Pandemics and infectious disease epidemics have been increasing globally, yet there has been a lack of research into personal protective equipment. Most research has been focused on drugs and vaccines. This is problematic because getting a matched vaccine to the population can take up to 6 months. In these situations, or where drugs and vaccines are simply unavailable, personal protective equipment can save lives, especially for frontline health workers. However, until 2009, no clinical trials had been conducted to determine the efficacy of PPE, and there was controversy about recommendations for masks during SARS, H1N1, and Ebola outbreaks. Led by Professor Raina MacIntyre and supported by UNSW, a team of scientists conducted the largest and most rigorous body of research on medical masks and respirators internationally. They began by testing masks and respirators in a household setting in Australia, looking at infection transmission from sick children to their parents. This showed the benefit of masks if worn as directed. The mask has a variable quality of filtration and is not regulated and doesn't seal around the face. The respirator is regulated and does create a seal around the face. From here, the team moved to the highest risk setting, comparing the continuous use of medical masks and N95 respirators among hospital health workers who were continually exposed to respiratory pathogens. The results show that respirators protect against clinical infections, but masks do not. While these findings make sense based on the design and purpose of the two options, they were controversial at the time because they challenged long-held dogma about PPE. In the third large randomized controlled trial, they tested out common ways of using masks, which until then had no evidence to support such practices. One such use was asking health workers to wear the devices in self-identified situations of high risk. Raina's team discovered that continuous use of the N95 respirator did protect health workers, whereas targeted use of the medical masks in self-identified situations of risk did not. This study, funded by the NHMRC, challenges the hospital guidelines, which only recommends targeted use of respiratory protection. Another important finding is that cloth masks used commonly around the world not only offer no protection, but actually increase the risk of infection. This is alarming, as more than half of the world's healthcare workers in areas where pandemics are likely to arise use cloth masks. The RCTs carried out by the team are by far the largest trials on healthcare workers that have ever been published, and according to one expert in the United States, have filled a critical gap in the evidence base for the efficacy and effectiveness of masks and respirators to prevent infection. The team had to use sophisticated methods to overcome the difficulties of the research, and have done several other research studies on masks, published in 22 peer-reviewed papers spanning health, economics, policy, and clinical practice. Not surprisingly, interest soared in the group's studies with the advent of the 2014 Ebola epidemic. This research will be vital for the future safety of healthcare workers, particularly those operating in high-risk areas of medicine globally. If healthcare workers are not protected from the spread of infection at the front line, then health systems will collapse. The MacIntyre team has produced the largest body of work internationally to generate level 1 evidence regarding the use of masks and respirators. This research has informed national and international policy and practice, and been highly cited in infection control policies and guidelines of leading health organizations, countries, and has informed international debate during key epidemics such as Ebola. As global epidemics continue throughout the 21st century, this research has never been more important.